I now call Deputy Guivi No Caolán. Can we have order, please, Deputy No Caolán? Order, please.
Punished yesterday, the Minister for Health. The Minister for Health told reporters that maternity services may be closed at a number of smaller hospitals. Now, he said this against the backdrop of his visit to Port Leisha and his meeting with the bereaved parents who tragically lost newborns there in recent years. And this follows his announcement last week of the establishment of a steering group to advise on the development of a national maternity strategy for Ireland, and who are to report by the end of this year. Now, we are all deeply concerned, irrespective of our political views in this House, at the series of tragic outcomes at a number of maternity units across the country, including at Port Leisha and at Cavan in my own constituency. And our thoughts are with the grieving parents and their families. We all want to know the full facts as to why these distressing events took place and what must now be done to ensure, as best as is humanly possible, that there are no further such incidents. Now, as Tánaiste, I have to ask you in the context of what the Minister said yesterday, because he has repeated it again this morning in the Health Committee, and it is fuelling further concern and distress at a time when we quite clearly have not yet got, you know, even the report of the new steering group. The Minister is being preemptive in suggesting closure of any number of maternity units. So what I want to ask of you, Tánaiste, is will you undertake to ensure that these sad and tragic, sad and distressing outcomes, surely, are not employed to serve a programme of closures, a long, make no mistake about it, a long-standing objective of some within our health services? And will you, in your position in government, ensure instead that all appropriate measures of address of the deficiencies and needs identified out of all the reports, some yet to present, we have none in relation to the Cavan incidents, that these are acted on or introduced?
Thank you. Tánaiste.
First of all, Deputy, I too want to express my sympathy with the families who lost children and who very bravely went and met the Minister over a prolonged period yesterday in Port Leash. And I understand from media reports told him their personal stories. To have the death of a baby either during childbirth or shortly after delivery, it's difficult to contemplate a more distressing scenario for a couple or for a parent involved and a mother involved in such a situation. And I think it's all the more difficult for women in that I don't think anybody is quite as vulnerable as when they're having a baby. I can't say enough to say how sorry I am for the families involved, for the parents involved, and particularly for the mothers. And also, having heard the distressing news about a further death in Cavan Hospital, and again what that mother, what those parents and that family must be going through, and again I want to offer my sympathy there. I think before answering your specific questions, I think we should be able to agree that the objective ought to be a health policy which focuses on the best outcomes for the baby, so there's a safe delivery of the baby, how much wanted babies we're talking about here, and the best health outcome for the baby and for the mother. The best outcomes have to be at the core of our approach to maternity and to maternity services in Ireland. I don't think that anything other than that as a policy is actually going to serve women and babies as well as it might. And, you know, it used to be said of Ireland that baby deaths and indeed maternal mortality were exceptionally low in Ireland. I don't know what the international figures are. I'm not an expert in the area. But I have been, as I think almost every woman is, every mother, every father is, shocked at the repeated reports of instances of deaths associated with our maternity services. So I think we need to agree that the best health outcomes for the mother and the baby are the first policy that we should agree with. In that context, I do think, and I welcome the decision by Minister Varadkar to have the review, the National Maternity Strategy Review, carried out this year. The strategy is to provide the policy to underpin the Women and Infants Health Programme. And the steering group to advise on the strategy met for the first time last week, and I understand had a very useful discussion. And as I understand it, the people involved in the strategy group are people of wide experience, both in terms of personal experience and professional qualification.
Thank you, Donna.
And I think that's as it should be. But I think we need to agree that the core of the policy has to be the policy that promotes the best outcomes for the baby and for the mother.
Good mouth. Supplementary question from Deputy Caoimhín O'Caolán.
And it's in total agreement with you that I take up my second opportunity. That has to be, and we can't have preemptive and prescriptive address of these problems, as I have to say, I believe the Minister's comments yesterday equate with. For the Minister for Health to suggest in the context of these tragic outcomes that maternity services at, and I quote again, a number of so-called smaller hospitals may close is, I believe, the wrong answer and one offered before his review group even commenced their work. Now, this statement by the Minister undoubtedly fits into the agenda, as I've said, of those who are advocates for more and more centralisation and who subscribe to the controlling obstetricians' view, and I say controlling obstetricians rather than obstetricians in general, view of child delivery. Now, I do not view expectant mothers generally as ill, far from it, or in need of consultant care. The overwhelming number required the services and supports of a midwife or midwives. Nowhere in the 8 recommendations of the report in relation to Port Laoise is the mention of closure. It just is not there. It is all within the gift of the system to address the deficiencies and the needs in order to ensure a safe service for women and for the child or children that they're expecting. That is absolutely what you've said, and I agree, must be at all times the critical focus. So I again appeal to you, Tánaiste, because I believe, and I am concerned, that there is an agenda being oxygenised here, that you should ensure that all of the assessment is allowed to do its work, and not to allow an agenda of some seize the moment and set the scene for the closure of any number of our now remaining 19 maternity units across the country.
Thank you, Deputy.
In conclusion, will you defend the right of women to access a safe service of their choice and not to be pressed against their will into heavily centralised conveyor belt child birthing settings?
Thank you, Minister.
In respect of that, and I thank you for agreeing that the best outcomes for mother and babies are the key objective. But, you know, can I just say to you, Deputy, that in relation to the HICWA Port Laoise report, which makes 8 recommendations, and I just want to pick out 2, In terms of the recommendations for the Department of Health, number three is to develop a national maternity strategy. And in relation to the recommendations for the HSE, number six is to develop a strong clinical network. Now, I think they're very important recommendations. And just let me say, in that context, what has happened already is that firstly, the Minister has actually developed the group to further develop the National Maternity Strategy. I think that's right. Because I think people do have to sit down and look at where we are now, what are the resources and what will produce the best outcomes. So I think that's good and I think it should be welcomed. The second thing is to develop the strong clinical networks. Now, we do have a very long maternity services tradition in this country, which has been very good in terms of commitment of the people who work in it, from the obstetricians, the midwives, and all of the other people who work in it, to the health of mothers and babies, going back over generations. So in the case of Portlaoise, what has already happened, and maybe it's something that might be explored in relation to Cavan, is that a network has been developed in the context of the Dublin and Midlands Hospital Group, whereby the Coombe Women's Hospital, which is a recognised international centre of excellence, with a very high number, as we all know, of annual births. And we do know that there is a correlation, particularly when there are difficulties with births, which offer very challenges either to the mother or the baby, in having medical expertise which has a high volume of experience.
Thank you.
We know that in relation to other areas. So the fact that the relationship with the Coombe, with Portlaoise, has already been established in respect of a protocol, I think that makes an awful lot of sense. That will have to be obviously resourced. The Minister, I've had a private conversation with the Minister about this. I think that that is actually a good approach. It does require resourcing. It has already, we know from Portlaoise, that there have been significant additional resources. There have also obviously been failures in relation to the practice of what we have come to expect as a people from our medical services, and obviously elements of that, including the management issues that arise, are under examination.
Thank you,
again, I think that is the right way to approach it.
Margaret, thank you.